got to be something here.
Uh-oh. Nobody's here. This doesn't bode well.
Dorian.
Father. So the whole story about the family retainer was just, what, a smokescreen?
Then you were told. I apologize for the deception, Inquisitor. I never intended for you to be involved.
Of course not. Magister Parvus couldn't come to Skyhold and be seen with the Dread Inquisitor. What would people think? What is this exactly, Father? Ambush? Kidnapping? Warm family reunion?
This is how it has always been.
Considering you lied to get him here, Dorian has every right to be furious.
You don't know the half of it. But maybe you should.
Dorian, there's no need to.
I prefer the company of men. My father disapproves.
That's a big concern in Tevinter, then.
Only if you're trying to live up to an impossible standard. Every Tevinter family is intermarrying to distill the perfect mage, perfect body, perfect mind, the perfect leader. It means every perceived flaw, every aberration is deviant and shameful. It must be hidden.
I'll need you to explain that.
Did I stutter? Men and the company thereof, as in sex. Surely you've heard of it.
I've more than heard of it, actually.
No. The Herald of Andraste. I am shocked and scandalized.
Such sarcasm.
You're not exactly subtle, O Lord Inquisitor.
I should have known that's what this was about.
No. You don't get to make those assumptions. You know nothing about the Inquisitor.
This is not what I wanted.
I'm never what you wanted, Father. Or had you forgotten?
So that's what all of this is about. Who you sleep with.
That's not all it's about.
Dorian, please. If you'll only listen to me.
Why? So you can spout more convenient lies? He taught me to hate blood magic. The resort of the weak mind. Those are his words. But what was the first thing you did when your precious heir refused to play pretend for the rest of his life? You tried to change me.
I only wanted what was best for you.
You wanted the best for you? Your fucking legacy. Anything for that.
Don't leave it like this, Dorian. You'll never forgive yourself.
Tell me why you came.
If I knew, I would drive you to the Inquisition.
You didn't. I joined the Inquisition because it's the right thing to do. Once, I had a father who would have known that.
Once, I had a son who trusted me. A trust I betrayed. I only wanted to talk to him, to hear his voice again, to ask him to forgive me.
He says we're alike. Too much pride. Once I would have been overjoyed to hear him say that. Now I'm not certain. I don't know if I can forgive him.
He tried to change you.
Out of desperation. I wouldn't put on a show, marry the girl, keep everything unsavory, private and locked away. Selfish, I suppose. Not to want to spend my entire life screaming on the inside. He was going to do a blood ritual. Alter my mind. Make me acceptable. I found out. I left.
What your father did was wrong.
I think he knows that. It's just hard for him to admit. Thank you for bringing me out there. It wasn't what I expected, but... it's something. Maker knows what you must think of me now, after that whole display.
I don't think less of you. More, if possible.
The things you say.
I mean it.
My father never understood. Living a lie, it festers inside of you like poison. You have to fight for what's in your heart.
I agree.
I see you enjoy playing with fire, Inquisitor. At any rate, time to drink myself into a stupor. It's been that sort of day. Join me sometime, if you've a mind.
The Inquisitor's work is never done, I see.
I need to talk to you.
Just talk? Such a pity.
Let's do something interesting.
More interesting than wandering the countryside killing random strangers?
Perish the thought. Come, we'll watch your soldiers bash each other with sticks while I critique their uniforms.
What's wrong with their uniforms?
Getting ahead of yourself, aren't you? I have a list. Let me find it.
What can I do for you?
I need to know more about Corypheus.
We spoke of this on our travels to Skyhall. What more can I tell you? Cassandra and Varric seem more familiar with their adversary.
You've given me good counsel before. I could use some now.
My apologies, Inquisitor. My poor manners shame me. I claim no secret wisdom. That I will guess as best I can.
What can you tell me about the source of Corypheus's power?
According to the lore, the ancient magistars of Devinta received guidance from the old gods. Corypheus commands a false archdemon, a corrupted old god. This suggests he no longer sees himself as their minion. Some of his unique power comes from the corruption of the Blight. The rest may come from the orb he carries.
I'd like to know more about the orb he carries.
As I said, that must be the means by which he created the breach. I suspect the blast that destroyed the Conclave was more accident than anything, the result of unlocking power that had sought release for ages. What I cannot understand is how he managed to survive such an explosion.
You said that you believe the orb is elven.
I never would have believed a Devinta mage could unlock such a powerful relic. It clearly enhances his abilities, giving him access to power he should never have known.
Like the power to control the Archdemon.
Indirectly, one assumes. Nothing in any lore connects my people to the old god dragons who became archdemons.
What do you think Corypheus will do next?
You shamed him when you destroyed Haven. Spoiled his glorious victory. It would be worse to acknowledge that you had done so. He must continue on his course or show weakness. He will return to his plans to throw Orlais into chaos, and then conquer it for Devinta.
You're sure that's what he'll do?
As certain as is possible. Assuming I can plausibly predict a man who seeks to rise to godhood.
Can you?
The key is understanding this. No real god need prove himself. Anyone who tries is mad or lying. His deception will undo him, as it has done countless fools before.
We'll talk later.
Goodbye.
I've news, sir.
What is it?
Could prove useful, sir.
There must be a way to get to the rift in the lake.
Maybe the locals will lend us a boat.
Stay to fight the undead here.
My orders forbid it. Crestwood was only a detour.
Is that all the aid we can offer these people?
If the Inquisition can help, I beg you to do what you can. The villagers have already lost too many.
What are you doing in Crystal?
Looking for another warden, Sir Loghain. He's wanted for questioning. If you see him, I'd keep your distance.
What have you been told about this rogue warden?
Warden Commander Clarell ordered his capture. I can say no more than that. Maker willing, Loghain will lay down his arms when we meet. I've no wish to fight the man.
Farewell.
Farewell.
Sir, are you sure we can't help the village?
Our orders are clear. If we can't find Warden Loghain, we return to the commander with all haste.
I wish we had more proper chevaliers in the Inquisition and fewer low-life thugs.
No matter how much you pretend I'm furniture, I'm still a person with ears that can hear you.
You recognize yourself there. Good.
Undead by the gates.
Ready when you are.
Live in the village while this is going on. Maker, if something happens...
Are you looking for someone named Judith?
Oh, was I speaking out loud? Judith lives outside the village. I asked her to hide here when the undead came, but she wouldn't hear it.
Why wouldn't she hide where it's safer?
Likes her space, she says. I told Judith my house was big enough. Me and the boy could sleep in the barn if she wanted room. She turned me down.
Good day to you.
And to you.
Please! May I use your assistance?
Visitor. Oh, Mayor Dedrick of Crestwood Village, at your service, despite everything. Are you here to stop the undead.
We will, right? I mean, these people are terrified.
The undead are appearing because of a rift in the Fade. How can I get to it?
The light in the lake? It's coming from the caves below Old Crestwood. Darkspawn flooded it 10 years ago during the Blight. Wiped out the village, killing the refugees we took in.
I saw a dam. If we use it to drain the lake, I can get to that Fade Rift.
Drain the... There must be some other way.
Your people are frightened, and they're tired. Let us help.
You'd have to evict the bandits in the old fort to use the dam. I can't ask you to risk your life.
Trust me, I've fought worse than bandits and the undead.
Then I have no choice. This key unlocks the gate to the dam controls past the fort. The rift must be in the caves under Old Crestwood. But, Inquisitor, I would not linger there.
I'm surprised a town as small as Crestwood outlasted the Blight.
It was a close thing. The Darkspawn followed a band of refugees running from the Blight. Some of the refugees were... they were very ill. But we took them in. They perished when the Darkspawn flooded Old Crestwood.
How did Darkspawn manage that?
They found the dam's controls, wrecked them. All I remember is the refugees and villagers screaming as they drowned. And now, they return to us.
Until later.
Of course.
Did you see how the Grey Warden saved me from those corpses? They're amazing. I'm going to see if they're looking for recruits.
You want to join the Grey Wardens now?
You're the Inquisitor. But yes, the Wardens are heroes. They saved me from those demons, Your Worship. With all that's happening, I'd like to help people the same way.
Grey Warden or no, the world needs more people with your courage.
And I wish you luck in their service.
Thank you, Your Worship. I'll make you proud.
Light and gold. You honor us, Inquisitor. I am Sister Vaughan. Does the mayor finally plan to drain the lake? I must find someone to retrieve the remains of those lost there.
You want to exhume the corpses at the bottom of the lake?
They were the Maker's children. Their earthly bodies deserve better than abandonment in a mire. A funeral service will help put living minds at ease.
I interrupted a funeral service.
We lost many friends in the first attack. There will be endless time to mourn. The fear is how many more will be added to the pyre.
What did you mean by finally drain the lake?
The undead returned only after the light in the lake appeared. If we want to stop them, we must investigate. But the mayor sent no one at all. Here, he thinks that emptying the waters would unleash even more monsters on us.
Until later.
Andraste guide you.
Talk about your dark and troubled past.
Excuse me?
Well, you have one, of course. Someone dear to you, someone you failed to save. Or a grave error in judgment, causing too many deaths. I've known a couple of people like that. Oh, maybe betrayal, that's always good.
No.
Well, you've got to give me something.
No, I don't. This conversation is over.
Touchy.
Decent place to camp.
Inquisitor. Nothing to report, sir.
Holt's contact with the Warden should be in that cave.
Glad you made it. I just got here myself. My contact with the Warden should be at the back of the cave.
He's not the only Warden around here. It's a good thing his friends didn't find him in Crestwood.
Yes. I saw them earlier. They've been told he's a traitor and ordered to capture or kill him. How much blood is shed by good men following bad orders?
Let's go.
It's just us. I brought the Inquisitor.
Warden Loghain MacTyr. I believe we have a common cause, Inquisitor.
There was a Loghain who joined the Wardens after he lost Ferelden's throne.
The traitor Terran. Yes. I've heard all the names.
Then that's you.
I've been a warden for 10 years. They will never fully consider me theirs. Something I've had cause to be grateful for recently.
Most of you wardens disappear. Then I run into a darkspawn magister named Corypheus. Do you think that one might have something to do with the other?
I believe so. After Hawk killed Corypheus, Weishaupt was content to forget the whole affair. If an archdemon can survive seemingly mortal wounds, why not Corypheus? I began to investigate. I found evidence, but no proof. And then, soon after, every warden in Orlais began to hear the calling.
You never told me.
I didn't believe it concerned you.
You think Corypheus is using this calling to control the Grey Wardens?
Not directly, no. The calling warns a Grey Warden that his corruption will soon claim him, that he is dying.
And every Grey Warden in Orlais is hearing that right now. They think they're dying.
Yes. Thanks to Corypheus, I believe. If the Wardens fall, who will stop the next blight? That is what's panicked my brethren.
Thanks to the calling, Corypheus has them scared, and they're playing right into his hands.
You said all the Wardens are hearing the calling. Does that include you? And also you, Blackwall?
Yes. It's like an itch, back of my mind. At times, it's barely there at all. But then I find myself starting to hum it under my breath. It is vile. I can understand why so many wardens have gone mad from fear of it.
I do not fear the calling. And worrying about it only gives it power. Anything Corypheus does will only strengthen my resolve.
Is the calling they're hearing real? Or is Corypheus mimicking it somehow?
I don't know. Even as a senior warden, I knew little about him. The wardens believe it to be real, despite my warnings about Corypheus. That is all that matters at the moment. This is, or was, once a mortal man. The Blight owns him, but it did not create him. Wardens are tied to the Blight through the Darkspawn. That is how Corypheus influences Warden minds. Somehow he is using that power to mimic the calling.
So the Wardens are making some last desperate attack on the Darkspawn.
A blight nearly destroyed Ferelden. A blight without wardens to stop it might well destroy the world. Warden Commander Clarell proposed a ritual involving blood magic. A desperate measure to prevent further blights. When I protested the plan, called it madness, they tried to arrest me. Grey Wardens are gathering here, in the Western Approach. It's an ancient Tevinter ritual tower. Meet me there, and we will find answers. If we wish to stop my fellow wardens, we should get to their ritual tower at the Western Approach.
You said that Clarell was Warden Commander. I thought that the Hero of Ferelden led the Wardens.
There's more than one Warden Commander. Each oversees a region, most often a single nation. The man you speak of was Warden Commander of Ferelden. He disappeared some time ago. It's possible he joined the rest of the Wardens, although I cannot say for certain.
I heard something of what happened in Ferelden. How is it you weren't executed?
When your mistakes are public, everyone feels they have the right to a personal apology. In the final hours of the Blight, the Wardens were short-handed. They needed every soldier they could get. The rest of my life will be my penance.
How did you end up an enemy of the Wardens again?
When the calling began, I searched as much as anyone for an answer. I protested the rituals, but faced little resistance until I began to investigate the death of Corypheus. The Warden mages branded me a traitor and attacked. When I defended myself, Clorel ordered my death.
Corypheus was imprisoned by the Wardens, right? So they must know who or what he is.
Secrets are a habit with the Wardens. One that costs many lives. Some knowledge is too dangerous to share. I knew little of Corypheus, and that was more than most. No one thought that knowledge could be vital.
I'd like to know more about Warden Commander Clorel.
I've served under her since coming to Orlais. She seemed fair. Dedicated. Perhaps that was the problem. I, more than anyone, know the cost of too much dedication.
Do you think Clorel is acting of her own volition?
Calling does not control minds, and I doubt Clorel could fall to Corypheus without others noticing. Whatever mistakes she makes of her own accord. Hopefully, we will learn more in the Western Approach.
I'll talk to you later.
Of course.
I heard what he said. Hopefully we'll find some answers in the Western Approach, though I fear what those answers will be. I've seen too much blood magic to ever trust where it leads.
Let's go.
You are quite the artist with that bow, Varric.
Now, Bianca does most of the work.
You have to aim her. Precisely. I don't think I could do that.
Too attached to hitting things with your fists?
Exactly. And just being in the thick of it.
I'll stick with bows. I really like having my own teeth. something?
I've read your Tale of the Champion, and I have a few questions.
That's a pretty common reaction. Go ahead.
Carry on.
Would you guess such a pairing?
Oh, yes. The lure of classically arousing.
Let us begin. How are the rescue efforts? Have they found anyone alive?
Excavation is slow, as you can imagine.
Let's see what we have.
Welcome to the Western Approach. We've sighted Warden activity to the southwest, but no one's been close enough to figure out what they're doing. Between the sandstorms and the vicious wildlife, we haven't made it far out here. One of my men got too close to a poison hot spring and gave me a slightly delirious report of a high dragon flying overhead. In short, this might just be the worst place in the entire world. Be careful out there.
Well, it's good to know what I'm in for.
Sorry I don't have more for you. We intercepted a Venatori messenger and, persuaded him to give up the orders he was carrying. We have them here. This entire place. It just feels like something's not right. Be careful.
Dispatch for you.
What is it?
See for yourself, sir.
happened here.
Well, here are the missing owners of those carts.
Ship 2, Frederick of Serrault. Who in Andraste's name would be out in this desert, aside from us?
What happened here?
Nobody should be out here but Grey Wardens. Something's very wrong.
Chantry symbol out here. Odd.
Good. Whatever's happening has already started. We saw lights coming from the tower.
You take point. I'll guard your backs.
Wait! No!
Warden Commander Clarell's orders were clear.
This is wrong!
Remember your oath. In war, victory. In peace, vigilance. In death.
I'm sorry.
Sacrifice. Find it just as I showed you. Inquisitor, what an unexpected pleasure. Lord Livius Edamond of Virantium, at your service.
You're no warden, mage.
And you found the Inquisitor and came to stop me. Shall we see how that goes?
It looks like you've already done some of my work for me.
What, him? We simply needed his blood. Oh, were you hoping to garner sympathy? Maybe make the wardens feel a bit of remorse? Wardens, hands up! Hands down!
Corypheus controls them. In desperation, they turn to the Imperium.
I went to Clarell full of sympathy, and together, we came up with a plan. Raise a demon army, march into the deep roads, and kill the old gods before they wake.
Corypheus marching across Orlais with an army of demons. That was in the future I saw at Redcliffe.
And now you know how it begins. Sadly for the Wardens, the binding ritual I taught their mages has a side effect. They are now my master's slaves. This was a test. Once the rest of the Wardens complete the ritual, the army will conquer Thedas.
Do you really want to see the world fall to the Blight? What do you get out of this?
The Elder One commands the Blight. He is not commanded by it, like the mindless Darkspawn. The Blight is not unstoppable or uncontrollable. It is simply a tool.
Somebody's certainly a tool.
As for me, while the Elder One rules from the Golden City, we, the Venatori, will be his god-kings here in the world.
So Corypheus influenced the Wardens and made them do this ritual?
Made them? No! Everything you see here, the blood sacrifices to bind the demons, the Wardens did it of their own free will. Fear is a very good motivator, and they were very afraid.
That's a lie. The Grey Wardens are heroes. They would never do this willingly.
The Grey Wardens care about nothing save stopping blights. They will do anything to accomplish that. You should have seen Clarell agonize over the decision. Burdens of command, I suppose.
Why would the Wardens try to kill the old gods?
A blight happens when Darkspawn find an old god and corrupt it into an archdemon. If someone fought through the deep roads and killed the old gods before they could be corrupted, woof! No more blights, ever. The Wardens sacrificed their lives and saved the world. Although I fear history will remember them a little differently now.
Why would Clarel risk using demons?
Demons need no food, no rest, no healing. Once bound, they will never retreat, never question orders. They are the perfect army to fight through the deep roads. Or across Orlais. Now they are bound to my master.
Release the Wardens from the binding and surrender. I won't ask twice.
No, you won't. The Elder One showed me how to deal with you in the event you were foolish enough to interfere again. That mark you bear, the anchor that lets you pass safely through the Veil, you stole that from my master. He's been forced to seek other ways to access the Fade. When I bring him your head, his gratitude will be...
As you feared, the mages who completed the ritual are under the thrall of Corypheus. Sacrificed?
I knew the Wardens would go too far.
Erimond lied to the Wardens. They were trying to prevent future blights.
With blood magic and human sacrifice.
Despite their lack of wisdom, they acted out of necessity.
Everyone has a story they tell themselves to justify bad decisions. And it never matters. In the end, you are always alone with your actions.
In the direction Erimond fled, the only structure of note is an abandoned Warden fortress, Adamant.